this is only the fourth year we've ever done these awards, and it's only the second time we've actually got to do it in person, so it's fantastic that we're all here together this afternoon. So there were points this last week when we weren't actually sure if this ceremony was even going to go ahead. We're obviously in a period of national mourning, and we had to have discussions between ourselves and the university about whether such a celebratory event should go ahead. But overall, we just feel it's right for the winners to be here and to be congratulated in person and to give them a chance to share the work that they've been doing. But with this in mind, I just want to reiterate, we ask that nobody posts anything on social media about the awards. We'll be taking photographs of the presentation of awards, but we won't post anything until next week. So that would be great if you didn't do that. So on to the awards then. The glamorous occasion of the SMA Awards. There are three awards to present this afternoon. I will announce the winner of each category, and then if the winner could come up and receive their award from Duncan, my glamorous assistant over there, get their photograph taken, and then I'll invite them to come and say a few words about their winning project. I feel like I should have gold envelopes. I'm really annoyed that I didn't bring any. Maybe next year. Right, so the first category is exhibition, display or interpretation project. And the winner of this category is Worthing Museum, the National Trust and the South Downs National Park Authority for their project, Cissbury Ring Goes Digital. We'll give them a clap. So unfortunately, nobody could attend the awards from these organisations, but they have pre-recorded, in true Oscar style, they have pre-recorded a thank you. So we'll get that played now for you.
Good evening, my name is James Sainsbury. I'm the curator here at Worthing Museum, and we're extremely proud to have received this award from the Society of Museum Archaeologists. This project was a fantastic collaboration, and it really brought the archaeology of the museum together with the landscape of the Cissbury Ring. It was also particularly poignant timing because this linked in with the anniversary, the centenary in fact, of the discovery and the excavation of flint mines by gifted amateur archaeologist John Paul. We also had an exhibition linked to that in the museum, so thank you very much.
Good evening, I'm James Brown, an archaeologist working for the National Trust. On behalf of the National Trust, I want to say a big thank you for so much for this award and the recognition of the partnership, the work that was involved in this piece of work. Cissbury is such a special site for many different reasons. The Trust has always struggled with how best to tell its story and celebrate the layered histories at the same time, not distracting from why different audiences love it, either for their heritage or the nature or just the views. The approach piloted at Cissbury has received incredibly positive feedback from our visitors, but additionally, inside the National Trust, our staff across the country are looking at how they might be able to develop this project and deliver it at their sites to best share their stories with visitors and members.
Hello, I'm Anushka Warden. I'm the Cultural Heritage Lead at South Downs National Park. This project was a huge team effort, and thanks to collaboration and partnership, we found a low-cost solution that capitalised on the growing public familiarity with QR codes due to the COVID-19 pandemic. We're really excited to see how this project might influence future opportunities that bring museums and landscapes together. So thank you so much for this award. Thank you.
Just to let you know, we will be posting details of the awards and some of the judges' comments on our website next week, so you can go and check out that project. So the next category is engagement and or collaboration project, and the winner is Oxfordshire Museum Service for their project developing digital access and community engagement pilot project. And we have to say, and congratulations. Would you like to come and share some of the details?
I realise that's quite a dry title for what turned out to be an amazing project. Is this going to appear on the screen? Yes. So this image saves me waffling on for 20 minutes. But the project started off as a way for us, firstly, to get images of our collection, digital images, because in that first lockdown, suddenly realised we had no great images. And so it was a way partly to get some images, and we did the digital outreach. But we called it a pilot project, so we wanted to stuff lots of other things in there as well. So as well as digital outreach on social media and virtual exhibitions, we had chosen Ensham in Oxfordshire and surrounding parishes, as I called it, the pilot area. And we also then wanted to meet people in Ensham. So I, as in true Oscar style, have certainly a list of thank yous. So the people involved with the team, the curatorial staff from the Oxfordshire Museum Service, Naomi and Lindsay, Portable Antiquities Scheme Officer, Ed, volunteers, Pat, Rosemary and David, who learned how to take photographs of small finds, do photogrammetry and 3D models, and hopefully you can see that was our first 3D, I'm saying ours, it was their first 3D model that they had produced. But also part of it was going into Ensham and meeting and engaging with co-curators, of which Steve is one of those co-curators has come along. So that's Martin, Victoria, Paul, Tim and Steve. And I'll let Steve explain what happened at the accumulation of all this sort of project work and our little experiments that we had with pop-up exhibitions in Ensham for the Heritage Day.
I've got some extensive notes here. Yes, it was. We had this Heritage Day on March the 19th this year, which was towards the end of the, you know, the lockdown, and it was an incredible success. Actually, it was a really fantastic day, wasn't it? And I think the part of the reason for this was, first of all, the enthusiasm by the Oxfordshire Museum Service, as encapsulated by Angie here and her colleagues. But also the response from people interested in history within Ensham. It's also down to the weather, which was amazing for mid-March. Peerless blue sky, and not too cold either. But it was also down to the variety of activities and events that we managed to put on, which appealed to different sections of the community. So that, for example, we had four different exhibitions. We had an exhibition of prehistoric Ensham in the local DIY window, of a mammoth tooth and a prehistoric hand axe. We had an exhibition of pottery discovered in the excavation of the Ensham Abbey site back in the 1990s. That took place in the library. Upstairs in the market hall, we had an exhibition of Ensham Abbey stones and associated artifacts. And downstairs, we had an exhibition of Ensham as it was through pictorial sources, so like prints and paintings and photographs. Outside, we had activities for children, young people, I should say, who were making medieval tiles, actually put on by one of your colleagues. We had a handling activity for people who wanted to see what and appreciate what Roman pottery was really all about. We had a number of tours of the village. We had a tour of the abbey site, which was conducted appropriately, actually, by the Roman Catholic priest. We had a tour of St. Leonard's Church in Ensham. We had a tour of Ensham historic buildings and those which are associated in particular with Ensham Abbey. And we had a tour of the local forge, which hadn't been open for about 40 years. In addition to that, we had a finds identification session. We had sales of cards and books and prints. We had really quite an amazing day, and the evaluation of it was overwhelmingly positive. And I think the numbers involved were an indication too. Entrim is, well, it's still called a village by people who live there. It's a small town, really, with about 5,000 people. We had over 400 people visit one of the exhibitions. On the tours that we did, we had 65 on two tours going around the Abbey site. I ran the tour going around Entrim itself. I normally have about 15 people. I had 79 on my first tour and 75 on my second. And it was such that people thought there was a demonstration going on in the village. I mean, it was amazing, wasn't it? And, I mean, we didn't charge anything, but I did, as a matter of course, I always put out a donation box. And at the end of the day, I was very pleased. We managed to raise 150 quid. So there's another indication of how successful it was.
So the project was funded by the Oxford University sort of funding through GLAM. And so I want to thank them for the funding and also the SMA for the award, because it means a lot, because then we're able to talk about it more. We're able to then try and replicate these projects, not replicate them exactly, but use it as a springboard for information. We learnt lessons. So Steve's tour of 79 people, I mean, Steve said, I'll be really chuffed if there's 15. We now know for the next projects that we're repeating in South Oxfordshire, we've got Eventbrite drippings, so we don't have to have curatorial assistants making sure everyone stayed on the path. But actually, they tried their best and did block the traffic in Entrim as Steve was doing his tour. But no, it means a lot to have this award, and so I'd just like to say thank you very much, and thank you to all the co-curators. Volunteers and the staff that put up with my frantic, oh my word, fire safety. What's the load? the load of the building that we had these displays in. Can it take potentially 30 people coming in? But anyway, I had a couple of sleepless nights. But no, it was a brilliant, brilliant project, and certainly the collaborations with the DIY shop and the library. We're all still talking about it now. So no, thank you very much.
Thank you, Auntie. Congratulations again. And our final category this afternoon is the Volunteering Award, where we like to celebrate our dedicated museum volunteers, without whom many of the projects we'll work on just wouldn't happen. And the winner of this award is Northamptonshire Archaeological Resource Centre.
So, thank you everyone. Yeah, thank you. It's a really great honour to be given an award for this. As you can see, I'm not really the best at accepting things like that. So, but I really wanted to put us forward for this for the work of our amazing volunteers. I'm not going to go on too much about it because I've already spoken to everyone about it today. But yeah, it's been a really good project working with all of the volunteers we've had in so far. And it's also not just those who have been volunteering inside the Archaeological Resource Centre, but also on our excavation. And we also have volunteers throughout our site doing other things like helping in our cafe and things like that, which all support. So, yeah, it's just really nice to have an acknowledgement from, you know, a national organisation about how great our volunteers have been. Because I know how great they've all been, but
most of them don't volunteer at other places, they don't know about the wider picture, so it's really nice to have some acknowledgement of what they've been doing. So thank you. And I should also say thank you to Lenscape as well, who were a partnership organisation that helped us recruit all of those volunteers. So they were really, really useful. And they've also helped with the admin and sort of HR side of things, which has been really, really useful. But enough of me rattling on. I'll pass you over to Dale, who is one of our star volunteers. He's been supervising the group, and he'll talk about why he does it. And, yeah.
Thanks, Ben. Firstly, thanks to Ben for making everything possible and for the volunteers themselves. I think I've got sort of two angles, really. So I'm a PhD researcher, and my project is looking at violence against women in the early medieval period. So for that, as an osteologist, I really need lots of collections of human remains, and Ben has kindly made all of those accessible. And has also been incredibly supportive. So I think this is a plug, really, for PhD researchers, that a lot of you guys have got some really important collections that are probably dusting away on shelves that are really useful to people like me. And unfortunately, I've run out of Anglo-Saxons at the ARC, so I'm looking for some more Anglo-Saxons. So I might be pestering you by email or at the dinner later on. And the second sort of angle is the volunteering angle. So as part of that, as part of my research, and as an ex-teacher, what I really enjoyed doing was training other people to do osteology work. And it helps being an ex-teacher, but it is those sort of skills are really transferable. And Ben's already talked about the skill levels of those 75 people, and you've got some really, really talented people who very quickly pick up things like human anatomy and how to side bones and how to age and set skeletons, to the point where they can do all that sort of stuff with minimal supervision from me. And like a lot of you, Ben's got collections going back to the 1960s that some of them hadn't even been cleaned, and they were just bones in a box. So we've sort of, as far as we can, brought them back to life. But the sort of the pleasure and that the volunteers have gained from that is huge. They've learned new skills. They've become a really sociable group that talk a lot to each other. We've got WhatsApp group. All of those things are really important, particularly for people who, you know, have retired and might find it not that easy to sort of make social contact with others. And I think it's a really important resource, the volunteers and the ARC itself.
Thank you. Congratulations again. Such a fantastic project. So that concludes the 2022 SMA Awards. Thank you to everyone, to our winners, and to everybody who entered the awards this year. I also want to thank the judges who did a fabulous job assessing all the entries, and they do it in their own time, and it's not always an easy job. So Liz Montgomery, Andrew Ferrara, Sean Isles, and Kevin Booth, let's give them a round of applause. So we'll be posting about it, as I said, next week, and I encourage everyone to think about projects that you're working on at the moment that you've recently completed and entering into our awards next year. Now I'll hand you over to Duncan. Thank you.